Hey guys, what's happening? My name's Cal, and in today's Java and Android Studio tutorial, we're going to be building a very simple calendar view application. So it's just going to be a basic calendar view. You know, you can go through the months forwards and back. We're going to make sure that Monday lines up with the first of each month, and we know we've got the correct number of days in each month. And we're going to build it all from scratch. There's going to be no frameworks, so hopefully this is a really good building block. You could sort of take this calendar application and then build upon it, depending on what you sort of want to use for your app. But yeah, I feel like there's a lot of room to build from what we've got here and customize it to suit your app. Link in the description to the source code.
Cool, so new Android Studio project, empty activity. Just got to make sure that the minimum SDK is version 26. And I'm just calling this app calendar app example. And then the first thing we're going to do is head into our values. I'm going to get rid of all these purple colors and I'm going to add in a color gray. I'm also going to add in a color blue. And feel free to copy those hex colors. Doesn't really matter what the color is. That's just the little color scheme I've decided to go for. I'm going to delete the night theme. I'm going to remove everything in our theme and change it to theme app compat light no action bar. And we can head back into our main XML. And I'm just going to change the layout to a linear layout. I'm going to set the orientation to vertical. Inside that linear layout, we're going to create another linear layout. This linear layout is going to have the orientation of horizontal. We're going to give it a little bit of margin to the top and the bottom. So we're going to store our buttons and our year month in this linear layout. So I've just created a new button and I've given it a width of 0 dp, and we're going to give it the weight of 1. The height is wrapped content. We're going to give it text, so the little left sort of arrow symbol. Text color is blue. Background null. Text style bold. And text size 20 sp. And then I'm copy and paste that below our text view. So that's going to be our right hand button. So go to the next month. And we're just going to change our text view up a little bit. We're going to give it a width of 0 dp and a weight of 2. And we're going to give it a text size a little bit bigger as well. We're going to say text alignment center, text color black. Just change the text. So yeah, February 2021. That's the month that we're recording this video. And we're just going to create a couple of onClick listeners. So onClick methods, I'm calling the first one previous month action. And the next one is next month action. We're going to give our text view an ID. So I've just called it month year TV, so month year text view. And then below our linear layout, we're going to create another linear layout. This one's going to have a horizontal orientation as well. We're going to create a text view inside that linear layout. Width of 0 dp, height wrap content, weight 1. We're going to give it the text of Sunday. So we're going to have 7 of these text views in our current linear layout. We're going to align the text to the center as well as text size to 16 sp. And then I'm going to copy and paste that down 6 more times and just changing the value. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, etc. And then below that linear layout, we're going to create our recycler view. So I've just typed recycler view. We're going to give it an ID of calendar recycler view. Width and height are match parent. And then I'm just going to create a new layout resource file. I'm going to call it calendar cell. So this is for our recycler view. And inside our calendar cell, I'm going to create a text view, wrap content on the width and height. I'm going to give it an ID. I'm going to call it cell day text. Default text to be 1. Text size is 20 sp. And the text color of black. We're going to give our text view some constraint layout constraints, right of right parent, left of left parent, and that just puts it in the middle. And then we're going to give it vertical bias of 0.25, so it just sits a little bit higher than the dead center. We're going to create a new Java class. We're going to call it calendar adapter, and then another new Java class calling it calendar view holder. And our calendar view adapter extends recyclerview.adapter and then giving it a type of calendar view holder. And then we're going to implement those methods. We just click on the error message and implement the methods, and then our calendar view holder extends recyclerview.viewholder, and again just implement the methods. And then we're going to declare a text view, our day of month text view, inside our calendar view holder method and say day of month is equal to item view dot find view by ID, and then just give it our calendar day text. Back inside our calendar adapter, we're going to declare an array list of strings. We're going to call it days of month. And we're just going to create a constructor. So just right click and generate a constructor. And then inside our onCreateViewHolder, we're going to declare a layout inflator, calling it inflator, is equal to layoutInflator.fromParent, get context. And then we're going to declare a view, and we're going to say it's equal to inflator.inflate, give it our calendar view cell, parent, and attached to root is false. We're going to say viewGroup.layoutParams, just calling it layoutParams, is equal to view.getLayoutParams. And then we're going to get the height, so we're going to say layoutParams.getHeight is equal to, just casting to an int, parent.getHeight times 0.166. We're getting the full height of the view, and then timesing it by 0.116, so that we get each cell is exactly 1/6 of the full view. We just want to return our new calendar view holder and passing it in our view. In our onBind view holder method, we're just going to say holder dot, and we haven't done this yet, so I'm just going to head into our calendar view holder and just make it public and make our text view public as well, so that we can access it from our adapter, and say day of month dot set text, day of month dot get at position. And then in our get item count method, we're just going to return day of month dot size. Next, what we're going to do is implement an onClick listener. So I'm just creating an interface. I'm calling it onItemListener, void onItemClick, passing it a position and a string, calling it dateText. And then we're going to declare our onItemListener inside our calendar adapter and add that to the constructor. In our calendar view holder, we're going to declare calendar adapter.onItemListener. And same thing, we're going to put this in the constructor. After that, we're going to say itemView.setOnClickListener. We're going to pass it this, and we just need to make sure our view holder implements view.onClickListener and implement the methods. We're going to say onItemListener.onItemClick, get adapter position, and then casting to a string our dayofmonth.getText. Cool, and we're finally ready to head into our main activity, Java class. We're going to declare a text view, calling it monthYearText. We're going to declare a recycler view, calling it calendarRecyclerView. And we're also going to declare a local date, calling it selectedDate. And then inside our onCreate, we're just going to create a method called initWidgets, and we're just going to find both of our views by ID. So the first one is calendarRecyclerView. We're going to find it by its ID, calendarRecyclerView. monthYearText, find view by ID, giving it monthYearTextView. And then below that, we're going to say selected date is equal to local date now. So just giving it the current date and time. And then we're going to say set month view, and we're going to create this method, and we're just going to pop it below our init widgets method. We're going to say month year text dot set text. And we're going to create another method that we're going to give our set text. We're going to call our method month year from date. It receives a local date, and we're just going to say date time formatter, calling it formatter, date time formatter of pattern. And our pattern is going to be the string month and then the year. And then we're just going to say return date.format, giving it the formatter. And now we can set our month year text to our get month year string from our selected date. And then we're going to declare an array list of strings. We're going to call it days in month. And what we're going to do here is actually create another method to get our days in month, given our selected date. So we're going to declare an array list of strings. We're going to call it days in month is equal to a new array list. We're going to declare a year month object, calling it year month. I'm going to say year month from date. We're going to declare int days in month is equal to year month dot length of month. So get how many days are in the month. Declare another local date, first of month. So get whatever the first day of the month is equal to selected date with day of month giving it one. So get the first day of the month. And then we're going to declare another int. We're going to call it day of week, which is equal to first of month dot get day of week dot get value. So that's going to return an integer between 0 and 7. We're going to create a for loop. It's going to be an old style for loop. So we're just going to say for int I is equal to 1, while I is less than or equal to 42, add 1 to I. And then we're going to say if I is less than day of week or I is greater than day of month plus day of week, we're going to add a blank square. If it's before the first of the month, or if it's after the 31st or the end of the month, add a blank square. Otherwise, I want you to add the value of I plus day of week. And then we're just going to return our days in month array. And then in our set month view, we're going to declare a calendar adapter. We're going to call it calendar adapter is equal to new calendar adapter, giving it days of month, and our on item listener is this. Given that, we need to make our main activity implement calendar adapter.onItemListener, and then we're just going to implement that method, but we'll come back to that later. RecyclerView.layoutManager, calling it layout manager is equal to new grid layout manager. We're going to give it the application context, and our span count is 7. So we're going to have 7 columns in our recycler view. And then we're going to say calendar recycler view dot set layout manager, giving it our layout manager, set the adapter as well on our calendar recycler view, giving it our adapter. Next, in our previous month action, we're just going to say selected date is equal to selected date minus a month, and then set our month view again. And we're going to do the same thing in next month, but instead we're going to plus a month and then set our month view after that. And then in our on item click, if our cell doesn't equal nothing, so it's not a blank cell, and then we're just going to make a bit of toast and say you've selected this date. So really you could put whatever you like in here, but that's just an example of how you can get the onItemClickListener working with your recycler view. Cool, and I didn't like this not being a string resource. I've just extracted both of those strings to a string resource, and I also made a mistake. I need to make this minus day of week. I never declared selected date is equal to selected day plus month. And if we build and run this, you can see we've got a pretty basic calendar view. If you click on a date, it gives you that little bit of toast, and you can see all the dates should be correct. First of month is starting on the correct day of the month, and we even got a leap year there. So February 2020 was a leap year, so we can select February 29th. That was a very basic calendar view in Android Studio using Java.